They're among the oldest pieces of porcelain made in Europe. Their value is incalculable. But the most important part of the Meissen exhibition is not to be found in the display cases.
The highlight of the exhibition is Albrechtsburg Castle itself. It was the first factory. All these porcelain items in the collection, in the porcelain collection in Dresden, or those in private collections, all the pieces made up until the middle of the 19th century were made here, in these rooms.
Albrechtsburg Castle was once a royal residence. In the 18th century, it became the first place in Europe where porcelain was manufactured. The foundations of the firing ovens in the courtyard and the worn-down steps are a witness to the fact that the castle was a center of the porcelain industry for 150 years.
It was incredibly busy here. It was loud. A lot of banging went on. The horses powered the machines. It smelled of fired clay and of paints. It was very hectic. Several stories were added in between the old ones. This all took place in an old castle, and that's fascinating.
The castle became a factory due to August the Strong of Saxony. The local ruler was obsessed with porcelain, which until that time was known only from China. No one in Europe knew how to make it. Johann Friedrich Böttger was searching for the secret.
We don't know where exactly in the castle Böttger worked and did his experiments. There are a few theories. It was probably on the ground floor or in the cellars. We do know that the windows were bricked up so they could work in secret.
Böttger's experiment went on for 8 years. But due to the wrong mix, or temperatures being too high or low, the attempt to master the art of making porcelain failed. Success came in 1708.
The Europeans were avidly trying to make porcelain. It was a huge technological challenge, and then they discovered it in Saxony. A lot of coincidence was involved, but the right people were there too. August the Strong and Böttger. The new technology was a huge advance. You have to compare it to nanotechnology today.
The factory started production in 1710. At its high point, as many as 800 people worked here. They included a lot of specialists, like chemists and painters. The division of labor was very up-to-date for its time. The crossed swords were the trademark of the brand. By 1836, the castle was too small. The manufacturer shifted to a larger site, where it has remained to this day.
Everything is done by hand, from the sorting of the individual ingredients to mixing them and the making of the clay. That's something which touches a lot of people, me included. It's also guaranteed the survival of Meissen porcelain to this day, outside of the industrial form.
Meissen porcelain is more than a brand. The history of its manufacture is a piece of European cultural and industrial history. And it all started here, in Albrechtsburg Castle.